And welcome to another review of the Amphipod Running Light. My name is Pete. I am a certified RRCA running coach and runner. It's been about since August 2017, so not quite 2.5 years, but I did a review on the same brand. This one is the Amphipod Versa-lite Max, 160 lumen max, pretty bright. Got one hand here, so bear with me as I try to get the information for you. It says that it is maximum intensity light power. It has 6 LEDs, 4 white, 2 red. The impressive thing about this light is that it says the run time on here for the white at 80 lumens is 4.5, I'm sorry, 8.5 hours solid and 10 hours flashing. Now that's the high. The boost, which is the max or the 160 lumen, is 4.5 hours. That's what it's rated as. And of course you have the red light, which if you don't want, to have it as bright as the white, you can do that. And apparently on solid you get 8.5 hours and 10 hours on the flashing. So 8.5 solid and 10 flashing. Now I haven't had this light, and I'll show you what it looks like, the actual light. I haven't had this for maybe 2 weeks. I've used it for about 7-8 days, and I kept it on the white 80 lumen, which is pretty bright, but it's not the max or the boost. And I just left it on that the whole time I was running, and I've been running about 1 hour a day for most of the days. I run every day here. In fact, I just ran my 100th consecutive day yesterday. So, I needed a light that would hold a charge. My previous Amphipod, which looks just like this, just a tiny bit smaller, weight-wise, was a little lighter, but this isn't real heavy at all. It has a clip here that you can attach to your waist, your shirt. What I do is, since we run in the dark here before the sun comes up, before work, it's completely dark by the time we start and completely dark when we end. We have a running vest that Amphipod was very kind to send. They sent like a little care package, and that included for my wife and I a running vest, a water bottle, and I'm forgetting something else. Oh, a shirt, a nice little Amphipod shirt. So thank you, Amphipod, for doing that. So the vest is like basically this green color here. And it's like a reflective vest, which is nice, very light. So I just attach it to my vest, and it sits just above my waist, and then it casts out the light ahead. So the previous one I had a few years ago was a 60 lumen, and it's bright enough. And it used to last about almost 2 hours. And then I'd have to charge again. So recently, beginning of last month, right after Christmas, it wasn't holding a charge very long. Like it would last for about 45 minutes, maybe an hour, close to that. Then I had to charge again. So every day I was charging it, which was getting frustrating. I reached out to Amphipod, let them know what was going on, see if this was normal for the life cycle of the light. They said no. And the customer service person sent this light, the upgrade, the Versa-lite Max, which has up to 160 lumens. So I'm going to demonstrate without further ado for my rambling here, basically what it looks like as I cast the light out forward. And this is what I use every day when I run. I've been putting it on the lowest white setting, so that would be 80 lumens. I did a test run on it, and I did it all the way until it basically shut off. And that took me, I ran, let's see, Monday through Friday, and then Sunday morning of last weekend, I ran for 30 minutes with it on, and then I ran Monday, and then half of Tuesday. So yeah, 5, 6, 7, almost 8 days, and I got 7 hours and 15 minutes. Now, there's a battery indicator light here that'll turn on red when you know the battery's running low, and that lasted for about 30 minutes. So that's pretty good. It didn't just shut off, you know, within a minute or two. So that was good. So it lasted 7 hours and 15 minutes. On the package, it's rated at 8 hours and 45 minutes. So yes, it did fall short by about an hour and a half, which is considerable time. But to get 7 hours out of this is great. Now, that was only the first time and I fully charged it. So I'll continue to do it again and see if I get the same times, but you be the judge. I'm going to show you what it looks like casting out in front as if I'm running, and then I'm also going to turn it so that you can see what it looks like if you were actually approaching me with it. So let's see if I can do this in the dark. All right, completely dark, and I did this. About 6 o'clock in the morning here on a Sunday morning, so that you'd really be able to see the difference between the intensity light. So here is this is what it looks like down on my waist. This is the 80 lumen, pretty bright. Now, if I click it once, that's the flashing white. Sorry, don't want you to get dizzy there. And then if you do the flashing red, which I don't use, I guess if you're a cyclist more so, just because it's hard to see for people that are coming towards you, and also when you're running, like you're at a dance club. This is a solid red. Typically the reds, you're going to save more battery, it's not as bright. And then this is the bright, or the max. So let's see if we can see the difference between, I'm going to hold it right here. That's the bright, the max, 160. And I'm going to turn it to 80. A little bit, right? Try that again. There's the bright, the max. Sorry for the shadows. I'm using off my phone, but you know, hopefully you get an idea. Let me see if I can turn around this way and have you look. So maybe looking at the door there, you can see the brightness. Take my finger away. That's the 160. And as you can tell, I mean, it casts pretty wide. It throws it wide, the lighting. Now here's the 80, which I've been running. Still bright, right? I mean, I guess I'm expecting the 80 not to be as bright, but, you know, because it's half of the lumens, but yeah, it's working good. So I'm going to warn you, I'm going to turn the light around so you can see what it looks like. And I'm only doing this because if I'm running towards you and you're a cyclist or a car, you'll see the light coming. Now, of course, from a distance, it'll be bright, but I'm literally only an arm length away, so it's going to really be bright. So bear with me. This is what it looks like. Yeah, pretty bright, right? And that's two, basically, I'll shut it off so you can see. It's basically, whoop, diagonal, one, two lights. That's 80. Now I will do the 160. Can you tell the difference? All right, arm length's way again. That's the 160, and then I'm gonna change it to 80. A little, right? But not that much. Pretty bright. So, my overall review of the light is, I'll give it an A. I've only had it for a couple of weeks. But my initial impressions is that I will continue to use this light as my main running light when I'm running in the dark, which is pretty much in the mornings before work. I do have a headlamp, a couple headlamps, rechargeable and battery that I've used in the past, but honestly, I don't like it really on my head. I guess if I'm out hiking or so, it's not a big deal. But it also is good to supplement as well, especially if you're maybe doing like an ultra marathon or if you're out for a while, you'd want to, you know, you want extra lighting. But this is pretty good. It comes with a USB, which I forgot to mention, a USB cable right here, which is nice. And yeah, it's you can pick this up, it retails for $35, which may seem expensive since there are lights out there for like 10 bucks. But those use those little round C batteries or not C batteries, so what are they called? I'm not very good with like CR3032 or 3232. Now these guys are rechargeable, so all you do is basically, I'm trying this with one hand, is pop this off here and put your cable into that little slot right there and charge it. It takes a couple hours to charge. They recommend fully charging it, you know, to get maximum battery life. But if you're in a crunch and you have like 10, 15 minutes, you're like, oh crap, I gotta charge my battery. Yeah, you can do that. I don't know how much life you get out of it. If it's completely dead and you only got like 10, 15 minutes to charge, I don't know, you might get, you know, 10, 15 minutes. But they recommend full charge. So just be aware, this is a really good buy. The previous model I had, which was only a 60 lumen, is still $25. So for $10 difference, you're getting like a little more than 5 hours of battery life. I think it's worth it. So thanks again to Amphipod for sending me this light. I sent in the old one to them, and yeah, this is a very nice light. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do so. I talk about running. Again, I'm a certified running coach, but just really what I do kind of, you know, day to day on running. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.